Hi everyone, welcome to Power Semiconductor Drives lecture series. This is lecture number 11. In the last lecture we studied about one of the important speed control of induction motor drive is variable frequency control of induction motor drive. Now in this session we will complete VSI fed induction motor drives. VSI fed is nothing but voltage source inverter. This is the basic circuit diagram of voltage source inverter. Here you can use the different types of switches depending upon the power rating of the requirement. For example, if you consider for high power rating, you can use GTO or IGCT. IGCT is nothing but insulated gate commutator thyristor, whereas GTO is nothing but gate turn off thyristors. Whereas for medium power applications, we can use IGET, insulated gate bipolar transistors, and also power transistors are used for medium power applications. For low power applications, we can use MOSFET also. This VSI FET, that is, inverters can be classified based upon their output they are producing. For example, if you're producing a square wave output, then that inverter is called as a square wave inverter or stepped wave inverter. If you are producing a PWM inverter, pulse width modulation inverter, called as a PWM inverters. PWM inverters are better when compared with the square wave inverters in many advantages, like reducing the harmonics and increasing the performance of the system, comfortable when comparing with a square wave inverter. Okay. Now we can see here the main requirement of speed control method is by varying the frequency and by varying the voltage, you can easily control the speed of the induction motor. Because in the last session, we studied about VFI control method, that is V by F ratio should maintain constant to maintain a constant flux. That means we have to change both the voltage and frequency. By using this VSI fed induction motor drive, the circuit diagram will produce a variable frequency by changing the switches. Whereas the variable voltage can be obtained by connecting a here, the input side, we can connect a chopper or we can connect a control rectifier also. We can get the variable voltage also. Now we'll see, let us consider if it is a square wave inverter. Then the switching sequence will be T by 6. That means every switch will turn on with a time period of T by 6. That means if you consider 2 pi is the time period, then the switching sequence will be pi by 3. Pi by 3 means nothing but 60 degrees. For every switch, there is a difference of 60 degrees time gap. Like this, we have a switching sequence. And next one is the frequency of the output voltage is varied by varying the switches. Next one is the output voltage, phase output voltage of the inverter. Because we are considering here the square wave, this is the square wave. Output voltage for this voltage, output voltage for this square wave is, there is phase values, VAN is equal to 2 pi by pi VD sin omega t plus sin phi omega t by 5 plus sin omega t by 7. This 5 and 7 are the harmonic component. Sin omega t is the fundamental component. While calculating the torque generation, all the things we have to consider the fundamental component only. Okay. From this fundamental component, we can identify the RMS value of fundamental phase voltage. For this output voltage of fundamental component, we can calculate the RMS value. That is, RMS value is root 2 by pi Vd value. That means by changing the Vd value, we can change the voltage value. These are the different schemes of controlling of induction motor speed. Because we need a variable voltage and variable frequency, all the four schemes will produce a variable voltage and variable frequency also. In the first two diagrams, we can see we are using a square wave inverter, and the next two diagrams, we can see that we are using a PWM inverter. For PWM inverter, we need a diode bridge. Diode bridge is enough because there is no need of any control rectifier here, because PWM inverter itself produces a variable voltage and variable frequency. That's why we need just a diode bridge. If you have an AC supply, we need a diode bridge because we need a DC supply to the inverters. For that purpose, we are using a diode bridge here to convert a three-phase AC to DC. And the harmonics are emitted by using a DC link. With that, we are getting a pure DC, almost a pure DC to the PWM inverter. Then with the PWM inverter, we can generate an AC voltage to control the speed of the induction motor. In the last diagram, this is the working. And coming to the third one, here PWM inverter is using, so there is no need of any control rectifier in the input side. For example, if you have a DC supply, then we can directly connect it to the filter, DC filter, to filter out the harmonics and to operate the speed control of induction motor. The second diagram also, we can see we are using here a square wave inverter. The square wave inverter means there should be a control rectifier we have to use. If we have an AC supply, then we have to use a control rectifier to convert the output voltage, DC output voltage, which is a variable one. And this output voltage is given to the DC link. And then it is connected to a 6-step inverter. Okay. And coming to the first one, these also we are using here a square wave inverter, in the case of DC supply, we have having a DC supply, then we need to use a chopper. Chopper will produce a fixed DC to a variable DC, and then it is given to the harmonics, that is the inner the harmonics, so it is given to the DC link. These are possible schemes in VSA control. These are the drawbacks of stepped wave inverter. The major drawback is it produces harmonics at low frequency. Due to the production of harmonics, it produces more losses in the machine, and the derating of the machine will decrease. It also decreases the efficiency of the machine. Due to the harmonics, it produces a pulsating torque at low frequency, so it creates a jerky motion at the low speed operations. And due to the harmonics, there is a possible of overheat generations at low speeds. For that purpose, there is a limitations in the speed control. That is, you can control up to 40% of base speed by using this method. This is a PWM inverter fed index motor drive. Here, pulse width modulation. The pulses are generated by using two signals. That is, carrier signal and modulating signal or reference signal. Carrier signal is a triangular wave signal and the modulating signal is a square wave signal. By comparing these two, we are generating the pulses. These pulses are used to operate the switches. So with this, we can eliminate the harmonics in the operating of an inverter. That's why the PWM inverters are better when compared to the square wave inverter. Here the modulation index is nothing but ratio of carrier signal amplitude and reference signal amplitude. That means here the reference signal amplitude is almost all constant. Reference signal amplitude is nothing but the sine wave signal amplitude is almost all constant. That means the modulation index depends upon the amplitude of carrier signal, that is a triangular wave signal. By controlling this modulation index, we can control the V value. From the first equation, you can see V is equal to M into Vd by 2 root 2. This is the PWM inverter output voltage frequency, output voltage formula. This is the PWM inverter fundamental component output phase voltage. V is equal to M into Vd by 2 root 2. Here, by varying M value, we can change the V value also. That means M value can be depends upon the amplitude of carrier signal. Finally, the output voltage of PWM inverter is controlled by changing the amplitude of carrier signal. What are the features of PWM inverter? Its control scheme is somewhat complicated when compared to that, because we have to generate a separate gating circuit, we have to create, and the size of the filters are decreased applicable for, because we are reducing almost all harmonics, lower order harmonics, so the size of the filter will reduce, and it is applicable for low and medium power up to 450 kVA. And next one is efficiency affected by the switching losses. Due to the switching losses, efficiency will also affected here. And constant DC link voltages are used. Harmonics are eliminated. Torque pulsations are decreased. And line power factor is very, very good in this PWM inverter, because we are using an average inverter in the converting AC to DC. And it has produced a very dynamic and transient responses. These are some of the features of PWM. Now we'll move on to the braking operation and four quadrant operation of VSA. How we can use the VSA for braking operation, and also how we can use this VSA head induction motor for four quadrant operations. First one, we'll see braking operation. Braking operation, we have to convert the, for example, if you see the power input to the motor is P input is nothing but 3 times of V phase, I phase cost. That means it indicates that power is positive. Power is positive means the power transfer from inverter to the machine. This is the motor input. In this condition, phi value should be less than 90 degrees. If you want to operate the machine as a braking mode, or you can say regenerative mode, that means the power flow will be quite opposite to the motor input. For that purpose, what we will do is, by reducing frequency, we can reduce the NSVAR. Which is less than NR, that is rotor speed, which is less than NR. Actually, in motoring mode, NS is greater than NR. If you reduce the frequency, NS value will reduce. That will produce the relative speed will be a negative value. There is a negative value in the relative speed. There is a difference. NS minus NR will be a negative value, because NS is less when compared to NR. It produces a negative value. With that, we are getting the negative currents and negative induced EMFs. So the motor will operate in opposite direction. That means it will act as a regenerative mode. The power flow will travel from machine to inverter. Then the at that case, if you consider phi value is greater than 90 degrees, phi value should operate at greater than 90 degrees. This is the working operation of braking mode. How you are converting the motor to a braking mode. That is regenerative braking mode. How you are converting it? By changing the frequency value. By changing the frequency, you can convert the relation as NS is less than NR. If you're decreasing frequency, NS value decreases, which will creates a relative speed of negative value. With that negative value, we are getting the negative values of currents and voltage induced EMFs. Then phi value is operating at greater than 90, the power flow will be in opposite direction. It will access in regenerative braking. Coming to the four quadrant operation of VSF, right? How we are using four quadrant operation means, similarly in the previous case, we are converted the machine as a motoring operation as a regenerative braking mode. That means we have transferred the first quadrant operation, motoring, forward motoring operation to forward braking mode by using the reduction of frequency. And then coming to the third quadrant and fourth quadrant operations, phase sequence of inverter output voltage is reversed by interchanging the firing pulses between the switches of any two legs of the inverter. This transfers the power operation to quadrant 3, that is reverse motoring mode. By inverter frequency and voltage are increasing to get the required, the inverter frequency and voltage are increased to get the required speed in reverse direction. This is the four quadrant operation we are getting here. This is nothing but dynamic braking of ESC. The diagram consists of additional component, braking resistance, and a switch is connected in series with this. S is the switch here. And SW is the switch connected between diode bridge and a DC link. When this system is working as a motor, that means the machine is operating as a motor, then only S will be in off state and SW is in on state. Normal working operation will be done here. Whereas for dynamic braking, we have to convert this motor as a generator. At that time, we have to open this SW switch. SW switch will open and the motoring regenerative operation mode. In generating mode, the switch SW is open. Then the capacitor starts storing the energy up to the rated value. After reaching the nominal value, then S is in on state. Then S comes into picture, the S is in on state and total energy is dissipated through the resistance. Then when it falls to a nominal value, S is open now. That means by operating the switch S by on and off, we can dissipate the energy in the resistance in dynamic braking mode. This is the working of dynamic braking mode by using VSI. Next one is regenerative braking of VSI. In regenerative braking of VSI, we need the direction should change for ID value with a constant VD value. The direction of VD value will be same with the change of ID value. This is possible comfortably by using a dual converter. Whereas in recent trends, we are using a synchronous link converters. Synchronous link converters are similar as a synchronous motor. If you see the working operation phasor diagrams, the operating will be similar to the synchronous motor. That's why this is called as a synchronous link converters. What is the major advantage of synchronous link converter is it always maintain a unity power factor at input side, both during motoring and braking operations. Okay, that is the major advantage. Due to this, we have superior performance when compared to the dual converters. Now we'll see the working operation of SLC, that is synchronous link converter. How the synchronous link converter is operating when comparing with the dual converter is a better one. Because it always maintains an unity power factor throughout the operation, whether it is in a motoring mode or it is in a braking mode. For maintaining UPF under motoring mode, between the voltage and current, there should be an in-phase relation. Whereas for braking mode, there should be out-of-phase relation. That is, IS and VS value should be 180 degrees out of phase. From the phasor diagram, you can clearly observe that for braking mode operation, IS and VS values are 180 degrees out of phase. And whereas for motoring mode operation, IS and VS are in-phase with each other. That is to maintain a UPF. These phasor diagrams will indicate a similar phasor diagrams of synchronous machine. Hence, this one is called as a synchronous link converter. You will see the basic circuit diagram here. This is the basic circuit diagram of SLC converters. The SLC converters which has a combination of LS and PW inverter 1. After SLC converter, we have a DC link and after that we have a PW inverter 2, which is used to control the induction motor speed. Here we are using a closed loop control which senses the capacitor voltage and compare with the reference value. With that error value, they are using a controller to generate a pulses here. Under steady state operation, PW inverter 1 voltage and PW inverter 2 voltage will be equal. That means there is no power flow taken between one and two inverters. That means we are trying to maintain a constant voltage throughout the capacitors. That means there is no error and the controller will not generate any firing signals because the sufficient firing angle is already working with the steady state operation. For example, if we consider there is a low increase in the load of induction motor, then PWM2 inverter will automatically drags more power from the DC link. This unbalanced condition will be sensed by the capacitor voltage and it is compared with the reference value. With that error value, PWM inverter 1 will automatically saturate and it will try to balance the voltages equal. That means PWM 1 in 1 voltage and PWM inverter 2 voltage will be at equal levels. This is the working operation, basic working operation you can see here. And some more points you can add here. SLC works as a boost converter because it will balance both the voltage sag and under voltage problems. For example, if you consider AC voltage fall, then closed loop operation will automatically controls and maintains the constant value throughout the working operation. That means it always tries to maintain a constant power and torque values throughout the working operation. That is the basic operation of VSI induction motor by using SLC. Okay. Now we'll see the closed loop operation control of VSI drive. This is the closed loop operation of VSI drive. This is the closed loop operation circuit diagram which we already studied in the synchronous motor control of VSI drive. This is a similar diagram. Here only change is we are using an induction motor here. Okay. So this basic diagram you can see, for a control of induction motor, we are using a PWM inverter. For PWM inverter, we need a DC input voltage. DC input voltage, after the DC input voltage, we are using a DC link. Then PWM inverter is controlled an induction motor. Every time we are sensing the speed of the induction motor, that speed sensor will sense the actual speed of the induction motor and it produces the signal to the error control error detector, which compares the reference value and present actual speed of the machine and produces a signal, error signal. And that error signal passes through a speed control, which is a PI controller, slip regulator also, because here the induction motor has slip parameter also. It will regulate the slip parameter. And after that, it will produce a WS star, that is a reference signal of speed after the slip regulator. And this slip regulator reference output is compared with omega m actual speed. And based on this error, we are getting a signal of frequency which is given to the PWM motor, and the same signal is passes through the flux controller. Here we have to maintain the voltage also, because if flux is saturated after beyond the rated voltage, that means there is a control block for that. So flux controller, from that flux controller we are getting a voltage value, and this voltage value is comparing with the actual voltage value from the stator voltage terminals. These two stator voltages are compared and produces an error signal which controls the PWM inverter. There is a modulation index of the PWM inverter. M value is controlled based upon this error signal ID star voltage controller block. Through this voltage control block, we are controlling the modulation index. This is the closed loop operation of VSFET. And the next session, we will see the CSFET induction motor control and also cycloconverter fed induction motor drive.